What could possibly be worse than 2020? The pandemic, the fake news hoax, the alien message decryption, the news of asteroid hitting the earth, and lots and many more. It seems that we all have really good and amazing plan for this year 2020, but all of our new year resolution, all of our plans, all of our future aspiration really went into another different direction. And many of the people lost their livelihood, and many of the other people really thrived their business to the next level. So in this year where we have seen an immense, extreme emotional reaction of the people, it really seems that, you know, this has been the worst year, and technically it is, in terms of economic and financial crisis as well. And today is the 31st December. That means the last day of this year. And what could be the best possibility to reflect upon what things that I have experienced, things that I have learned, and the things that I have unlearned especially. And this video is just a really take giveaways to share my experience about what I have really learned and the things that I have unlearned. Now, to be a fair warning, the lessons that I'm really, or the things that I've learned, isn't really a revolutionary. So if you're already expecting something crazy out of it, this video is probably not for you. But the things that I've really talked about, is generally universally applied to most of us. So the first thing is about emotional state and attention span. So before lockdown, I really used to go to meet my friends every month, for maybe twice a month. Okay, go to the meetups. I love to be social with the people. I love to seek knowledge, and I love to seek and gain knowledge from the groups, tech groups out there. And this was really part of my routine. Let's say I study 1 week. I used to go to tech meetups of AWS and try to study about what's the new topic, what's the new trends, like ask them question, try to get socialized. But as we know that during this pandemic, everything was sealed. Everything that really forced us to be within the global lockdown. That means everyone is there, everyone was within their home. And this really wasn't really, let's say I was assuming that it will really go fine. And for the first 1 or 2 weeks, it really went fine. But after that, within 1 month, I really started to feel something, a cog in my mind. There was really a cog in this, in the emotional state. I wasn't really able to focus more than, half an hour. Earlier, it was really like, within that February, previously, it was really like, I could continuously focus for more than 1 or 2 hours in straight go. It's really like, but this time it's been really happening that, hey, I'm feeling exhausted, my energy is getting burned quickly than it was really getting before. And I really asked my friend that, hey, I'm feeling this, are you feeling the same? And that reaction was, yes, we are pretty much feeling that same. And obviously, this reaction of mine is pretty much differ from a person different. Obviously, it's really going different from person to person. So let's say if you are an introverted person, you might be reserved within your own space. And the pandemic has not been hit hard to you. But for me, like an extroverted nature, it has does pretty much. And when I really just additionally searched on online what people are feeling, how is their journey going on, and I really found that it's really a kind of repetitive pattern, because it's a really a once in a lifetime experience that we are ever going to experience. So it's a really a unique, and it's pandemics are generally happen in every once in a centuries. So this was a kind of really a global scale thing, and this was a kind of really new experience for us. But during that emotional state, the one thing that I've experienced is hyper irrationality. So what is really happened is Robert Greene has made an brilliant video on it. Let's say I really suggest you to watch that. So he really talks about the people that we have suggested about, become too sensitive to the news, becoming too sensitive to, the alertness. It's a kind of really, teasing our own primitive nature about our primitive ancestor nature, that we were really supposed to seek the danger and to really try to test about how it works and what dangers are coming in our way. So it was really making us are more hyper irrational. And the second point that, or the second or the third point that I really say is the thing about managing resentment. Now, I'm a person with a background of knowing and processing stuff really logical and really a psychological way. I want to know about how this thing works, how this thing has its own origin, and how this thing has been really affected in people's life. So naturally, I have really, you know, I really like to break down things apart, and I really love science and engineering to its really to its deepest core. But on the part, it's really like we have a biases to certain assumption or certain particular things, and that we really stick and that we really tend to stick upon. Let's say a particular people really like their own religion, particular people really like their own things. So similarly, I was having an assumption that why people behave in the why people really react in such an irrational, stupid way. So as we see, you know, the TikTok, it's like it's banned in India right now, but let's say Reels, Instagram, or any other short videos app where we see people posting cringy, shit-worthy things. And we see the same patterns over on internet, on social media, and someone else's profiles. So I used to really think about why these people is posting so, you know, so mediocre or so low things, which I have already ranted about in my selfie video that I have posted on Instagram, which you can definitely check it out. Link is in the description. So I used to really have a lot of resentment towards the conventional thing about why this thing is really not working well. Why isn't really people are logical? Why people really want to just show off? And it's really, you know, kind of it, and it really made me during that own that emotional process. It just made my brain own cocked. And what it really happened is adding an emotional irrationality due to this pandemic, the resentment kind of really added a fire. And indirectly, I used to really troll a lot of people online, which is not a good thing. And that I really learned about a couple of months ago, that you should try to see the other side of the coin and renew and try to accept the people as who they are. It's actually, you know, an interesting thing when you really try to know and when you try to recognize about why people are behaving in a certain way that they are, you will actually be more gracious, or you will actually feel more gratitude towards them instead of feeling angry. You know, if you really just try to recognize or understand why this person is behaving in a certain way, you will see that this person is having this kind of tendency. This person has kind of really XYZ background. That's why he has been behaving in ABC way. And in order to really seek a neutral basis, you need to look upon contradictions. Now, what does that contradiction really means? For every opinion that you have, there is a contradictory opinion to it. Let's say I think that girls are awesome, or I think that girls are shit. It's really there is a counter opinion belief to everything that is there. So let's say I think that, you know, this political party is really great, or this political party is shit. Now what I can really do is I can have a counter opinion to it, and I can prove the both logical side. I can prove the both side logically correct. Now the point really comes that which one is more correct, because when we see logically, both of the sides are equally correct. Both of our perspective really seem to be, you know, correlate or co-dissolute like yin and yang together. So which one should you choose? And that is always a contradictory state to be hold in. And if you really just kind of see, you will see the contradiction in everything, in every topic that you believe. And it really makes the kind of sense of nihilism to kick in. That the world is just, you know, it has no meaning, but still we are living in. And yeah, I do believe in the sense of nihilism to a certain extent. But in the transactional world, it's not going to helpful by any means. So in order to really just kind of really neutralize what you think, if you have any strong opinion, let's say what I've given example previously, that girls or politicians, if you have some sort of any strong opinion, next time that you really want to verify, try to see counter opinions to it, and then try to really just say, your mind will probably get confused between both of the things, seeing together both of those things. Now you will have to choose one of them, And the thing and the nature of this reality is that both will exist, both will coexist together. Both can't be separate in their own sense. And that really leads me to the second next topic, is about the gender issues. You know, in this world of where the female empowerment movement is gone over, lots of corporations have really started taking notice about the importance about giving positions to female. Let's say the topic about patriarchy, the topic about women empowerment, the topic about feminism, the topic of everything. And it really becomes essential to study about what are these things that are really going to deep. What are essentially these things, and why it really behave in certain ways? Is there any possible rule? Because I'm myself going to really start up in this 2021. So it becomes really important for me to study about the human nature and the psychology. So in the basic psychology, I'm not talking about the clinical one. And the best possible thing to refer on this topic is Dr. Jordan Peterson's lecture and his interviews. Now, he has gone into the bunch of depth about why this thing exists, why there is an evolutionary base to it. Does patriarchy really mean something, or is it useful, or is it bad? If you are really interested in this topic, just go on to this thing, because the topic of controversy has been always exciting for me to really keep my thoughts in check and to make sure that I don't lean in any one side. To really always try to take both sides and to channelize both in one direction while making a decision. And the next thing is about knowing the importance of self-talk. This thing has been, you know, really been one of the wonderful years for me to in order to really recognize and to study about more and more on human nature. So this video, I have researched about ton of things on narcissism, let's say why people behave, let's say the sex psychology, the ancestral thing. It's like the best book on the history is like Sapien, that I've actually read in the 2019 itself. That was the best book on history that I've ever read. And it really had any, and reading all those things together linked itself to really kind of give you an elaborative perspective about what is going on in this world and how can you see this right together. And doing that thing, I really realized is much of the thing that depends upon what you become or who you are today is that the major part of it has depend upon what you self-talk within yourself, what you talk within your own mind, within to your own self. And nonetheless, one day I just shared this story on my Instagram and just shared about what my thought about self-talk was. And it's really seemed that self-talk really has a really critical thing, whether in your career, within your romance, or whether it's anything what you can possibly perceive, whether it's in a job interview. Let's take an example about, let's say if you happen to like any girl or boy, and if you go and think about it, let's say the kind of self-talk that you do within your head, let's say the boy is really handsome or the girl is really beautiful, the kind of self-talk that you do accelerate your own emotion and own thinking that is really going on there. If you just go above there and your mind stays blank, possibly the emotional state or that desire would not be that less. So let's give another example. Let's say if you really like a Rolex watch, I'm just giving an example, and if you really happen to get, and if you have an immense desire to get that watch, now what you will do is you will have constantly that tape within playing on the repeated loop within your own self-talk and mind, that will own in self amplify the desire within you. So let's say if you really haven't that any self-talk within you, would that desire really be that so high? Possibly not. So it's kind of really important to channelize the thought process and the self-talk that we really do in a particular way, because it really affects about what we think, what our thoughts are, and eventually thoughts does lead into action. And the most important thing that I really felt is about managing temptations. Now, I'm a person who really loves to learn and watch and various things, and sometimes it all backfires me because sometimes I love to, apart from this coding and this AWS stuff, apart from that, I'd love to do sometimes, you know, I get a desire of learning Photoshop. I love to be, you know, I love to see that, hey, Unmesh Dinda has made this. Now I'm really going to make this one. And let's say, hey, this photographer has, Peter McKinnon has made this beautiful shot. Like, how can we elaborate in my own video production? Sometimes it really kicks up, right? Hey, I want to do a relativity video. Or let's say I want to study relativity today. So there's a bunch of crazy stuff or many stuff that I really like to study at one time. But the fact is, you can't do everything at one single time, because you need to factor about what is the thing that is going to give you the maximum result. Given the fact, even, you know, taking learning the skill, even one skill takes is a lifetime journey. And it's kind of really hard to really master in every one of them. I mean, sure, you can learn, you can on the surface level try to learn as much as complementary skill as you can. But sometimes it's, I feel that, what result am I getting through this? Is it really helpful? Is it really accelerating me, or is it slowing my development pace? So according to that, you should really ask yourself, like, is it going to help me? Or why am I doing this? What's the purpose? For me, it's really to make about better content. So you need to take care about it. And the next thing is about reading books. Now, I have made another video on Instagram about why I like to read books. You can check that out in the description below. So the reading books is kind of really essential for me. So this year, in this emotional irrationality year, the one person that has really helped me to gain an immense knowledge was Robert Greene. His books about 48 Laws of Power, Art of Seduction, Mastery, the Laws of Human Nature has really helped me to give an elaborate perspective about what our human nature works. And I'm a kind of really person about, I really like to know. It's like, the more information that I get, the more stabilized that my mind really becomes. So, you know, in order to really just kind of know about it, it's really, if I'm really having some trouble, I tend to look about the solution within the books and in the online world, possibly, or by consulting any person out there, if it's professional enough, or within my friends, or in anywhere in general. So, you know, the reading book kind of really helps you to elaborate the perspective, and there are many bunch of positive benefits you might have possibly known out there. So if you can really, if you are having free time, you can check that link below. The next point that I really like to add is about my development phase, or that learning about this AWS and this like full stack web development. And the thing is really that what I really learned and try to understand is, sometimes we imagine that, you know, we have hurry to learn everything in just one go. And at least that's what I think. Let's say in the October 2019 itself, I thought that I could really finish learning AWS in just 2 or 3 months. That means max to max Feb or March 2020, that was, it was supposed to finish. But AWS is so vast, and there is really not a proper resource to learn at one go. And naturally, there wasn't any major resource. But frankly, now there are many creators that is really putting out a lot of content. So as time progresses, the things will really go much more better. So that is what I'm really, that's a really good thing to hope about. And that thing really took me a lot of time about to understand. Let's say, what is Lambda? What is Lambda Handler? What is DynamoDB? Why it has key store? Why it is not? Why the SDK is not really as simple as Mongo's? Why there is, you know, why there is such a really radical sense to make this pattern really work together? Or why these things really exist? So it really took me a lot of time. So the thing that I really learned is about, sometimes the things will not necessarily go according to what you plan. So it's important to have patience, and but also important to really work fearfully to, in order to work with full zest to on that issue. So in order to really solve that issue as fast as possible, and that really leads me to about the development of my Facemash project. So it's really where right now in the architectural process. So hopefully that will really, by the end of this first quarter, I will really complete my the first prototype, because right now everything is just finished. Now I have to just architecture properly and just try to implement in the real life scenario. Last but not least, be authentic and share your originality. The world really needs a fresh perspective about solving on the things that have really existed, the things that really needs to be solved, and the things that are really in this R&D process. You know, in the world of astronomy, to really strong, let's say in the world of astrophysics, in order to really solve the complex problem, we need a fresh perspective. In order to solve about the various engineering challenges, we need a fresh perspective. And the fresh perspective will come about from your own individuality and own originality. Sadly, in our culture, in India especially, we aren't really more focused on cultivating our own self, and we are kind of really carried away to really seeing others in the name of social conformity, which I have really mentioned in my own video about book summary about Robert Greene's mastery. You can check it above right here. So we need a fresh perspective, and that originality thinking really comes to upon, you know, seeing yourself, being self-aware, try to really just find out the things and try to seek the things that personally excite you, and try to really just kind of look upon it. And that's really pretty much wraps up my basic discussion about what I really learned, because and there is bunch of many other stuff like why we love drama, because what is the romance, like psychology of romance, and there is crazy other stuff, but this video is kind of really a base summarization for that. Let me know if you want that other videos as well. I can discover and talk about in later videos in future. So that really wraps up this video. So till then, stay connected, stay subscribed, and I'll see you next time.